Yeah, Wanda, what we can tell you right now is that police have just left the scene, as we said a short time ago. But obviously, people here are very shaken up. And let's take a look at what they have to say.
I live alone. It's a scary thing.
Sherry Geldner lives below apartment 303. That's where police say just after midnight Thursday, 34-year-old Enwan Dakam shot his way in and started shooting.
It's an assault-type rifle, so there are many, many rounds that were fired into the door to get the door open and then in the apartment.
When it was over, five people had been shot. 43-year-old Joshua Prego was already dead. Dakam's 6-year-old son Jason and a family friend, Ha Ding Ni, were badly injured and would die at the hospital. Dakam's former girlfriend, Ha Li Wee, was shot in the hand, and an unidentified 12-year-old girl was shot in the arm. Wee was able to run to a neighbor's to call 911.
He backed out into the bricks, hit the bricks, and as he was moving forward, I saw the blue lights of the police officer. He ran, hit him head on, and then was on the ground, screaming, "I just killed somebody, I just killed somebody, I shot somebody, cuff me."
That officer was able to crawl out of the passenger side window.
The officer was aided by a citizen in the complex who saw what was happening and helped to work to detain the subject. It's a sad day.
This is where Dakam called home. His next door neighbors are also shocked at what police say happened.
That's one of the most shocking things that I've ever heard, because they was perfect neighbors, didn't bother anybody.
Helped me do the yard, you know?
Yeah.
Cool guy. I didn't expect him to kill people.
They say they never would have guessed he was capable of committing such a horrible crime.
Well, I saw him either the day before yesterday or yesterday he was cutting his grass, and his kids was out there in the yard with him, and we always just wave.
And tonight, Dakam is charged with 3 counts of first-degree murder and 2 counts of assault with a deadly weapon with intent to kill, inflicting serious injury. He is being held at the Guilford County Jail without bond tonight. Reporting live in Greensboro, Erica Miller, WXII.